Today I will discuss on the abdominal lymph node imaging. So, lymph node in the body plays an important role in the immune system. It provides protection against organism neoplastic cells. Lymph nodes are also involved in the production of B and T lymphocyte and antibody producing plasma cells. The adult body contains around 500 lymph nodes with approximately 230 nodes in the abdomen and pelvis. Enlarged lymph nodes are common physical finding and not always sign of disease. Lymphadenopathy or splenomegaly may also be the first sign or even the only sign of a serious or life-threatening conditions. So, there are various points by which you can narrow down the differential diagnosis of the cause of the lymphadenopathy, like site where the lymph node are involved, the characteristic of lymph node, and the age of the patient, whether it is an adult or children, and presence of associated symptoms like fever, weight loss, etc. So, mechanism of lymphadenopathy. As we know, the physical enlargement of a lymph node can occur via several processes. Polyclonal lymphocyte proliferation due to a reaction to a specific antigen. Monoclonal proliferation from a malignant transformation of a lymphoid cells. Infiltration of the node by non-lymphoid cell, such as inflammatory reaction by neutrophil in lymphadenitis, metastatic spread of a cancer cell from a primary site of neoplasia. Location of lymphadenopathy. Normal peripheral lymph node chains in the body are responsible for drainage of lymphatic fluid from a specific anatomic location. Enlargement of peripheral lymph node in a specific area may point to a regional source of the abnormality. Drainage pattern of central lymph node, like a mesenteric, retroperitoneal, are less predictable. So, normal appearance of lymph node. As this image, this first image on this right side, that is an ultrasound image, and that arrow is showing there is a flattened hypoechoic cigar shaped structure, that is a normal lymph node. And on the left side, this CT scan images, this arrow indicated that a small soft tissue attenuating lymph node. So, what are the aims of imaging? Enlarged lymph node detection, characterization, accurate measurement, and the comparison with the previous study. Lymph node characteristics. It is a key physical feature of palpable abnormal lymph node. Include the size of the node, presence or absence of tenderness, consistency and physical conformation of the enlarged node or nodal cluster, whether it is a firm, rubbery, matter or confluent. The presence of nodal tenderness suggests an infectious or inflammatory pathology, whereas a non-tender stony hard lymph node indicates a malignancy. So, size criteria for various retroperitoneal lymph nodes in abdominal, if it is less than 1 cm in short axis, then it is normal. If a single node and that is the more than 1 cm in short axis diameter, that is suspicious. If it is more than 1.5 cm and it is single, then it is definitely it is abnormal. But if there are multiple lymph nodes and the size are more than 1 cm, then it is again it is abnormal. A retrocludal, if the size is more than 6 mm, then it is abnormal. And even the portocable lymph node, if the size is more than 6 mm, then it is abnormal. However, in the pelvic group of lymph node, if these lymph nodes are more than 1.5 cm, then you can say it is abnormal. However, size criteria are a very controversial parameter, as malignancy can be present in a normal size lymph node. And conversely, there may be a enlarged lymph node that may we not a neoplastic invasion. Disease specific sentinel nodes. In case of the carcinoma of the bladder, prostate, cervix and uterus, initially the pelvic group of lymph nodes are involved. However, in the case of the anorectal malignancy, initially the perirectal group of lymph nodes are involved. However, in the case of the testicular, ovarian and fallopian tube malignancy, initial involvement is the retroperitoneal nodes may involve the pelvic nodes by the retrograde spreads. The testicular carcinoma of the right testis tends to involve the autocaval and paracaval lymph node and can cross over the left side of the aorta. However, the testicular carcinoma of left testis, the left para-aortic group of lymph nodes are involved. The regional patterns of abdominal lymphadenopathy, the retrocrural space connects the posterior mediastinum to the retroperitoneum and contains the aorta, thoracic duct, azygous, hemazygous and retrocrural lymph nodes. Lymphatic from the diaphragm, posterior mediastinum, upper lumbar region drain directly to the retrocrural nodes and peritoneal cavity. Carcinoma, mesothelioma and lymphoma are the most common malignant disease to involve the retrocrural lymphadenopathy. This is a CT scan and this black arrow is showing there is a retrocrural lymph node, that is retrocrural lymph node in a 30-year-old patient. It was a case of the lymphoma. And this CT scan on the right hand side that shows the well-defined retrocrural lymph node, as well as the on left side the two retrocrural lymph node are showing, that arrow is showing. The retroperitoneal nodes, these nodes are present in a perivascular about the aorta and IVC and are grouped into the periaortic, pericaval and autocaval chains. The pelvic nodal drains directly into the retroperitoneal nodal system and there are numerous interconnections with the celiac and mesenteric nodal system. Any intraabdominal and pelvic neoplasm may cause retroperitoneal lymphadenopathy, but the most common are lymphoma, renal cell carcinoma, testicular, cervical and prostatic carcinoma. So this first image on the right hand side, that this is the case, this CT scan showing the large mental confluent retroperitoneal lymphadenopathy, and on anteriorly this arrowhead that is showing the mesenteric lymph node. However, the middle image that reveals the necrotic, arrow is showing this aorta, and posterior to this aorta there is a necrotic lymph node that is anteriorly displays the aorta. However, on the left hand side this ultrasound image that is showing there is a well defined rounded hypoechoic lesion, and anterior to this linear structure, that is aorta, that is displaced anteriorly by this lymph node. The gastrohepatic ligament node. The gastrohepatic ligament is the superior portion of the lesser omentum and contains left gastric artery, coronary vein and left gastric nodes. The gastrohepatic ligament suspends the stomach from the liver and blends into the fissure of the ligamentum venosum. A drainage from the gastrohepatic ligament nodes is to the celiac nodal group, especially in the case of the carcinoma stomach, distal esophagus, carcinoma pancreas. So this CT scan, this arrowhead is showing the ligament, this fissure. However, this arrow is showing the gastrohepatic ligament lymph node enlargement. Portohepatic nodes. Portal nodes lie within the portohepatic, extending down to the hepatico-duodenal ligament, and they interconnect with the gastrohepatic ligament nodes. And the portal nodes are abnormal if they are more than 6 mm in size. Adenopathy of the portal nodes commonly causes high extrahepatic biliary obstruction. Many primary neoplasms spread to the portal nodes such as gallbladder and biliary, liver, stomach, pancreas, colon and lymphoma. So this CT scan on the right hand side, there is showing multiple small hypodense lymph node. This arrow are showing, over on the left hand side there is showing the confluent portal lymphadenopathy. Celiac and superior mesenteric artery nodes, the celiac and superior mesenteric artery and base of the IMA nodes are termed as pre-aortic nodes and have interconnection with the retroperitoneal nodes. The celiac and SMA nodes are around the origin of their respective vessels. These two groups are receiving lymph nodes from the mesenteric, ileocolic, colic and portion of the pancreas. This CT scan images on the right hand side, there are the lymph node, they are clearly distinct with this celiac axis. However, on the right hand, on the left hand side, there are widely disseminated colonic carcinoma reveals a massive celiac lymphadenopathy that black arrow is showing. This CT scan, they are showing the nodes surrounding the SMA that just anterior to the vertebral body, that is the SMA. However, on the right anterior area, that arrowhead is showing the lymph node. Pancreatico-duodenal nodes lie between the duodenal sweep and pancreatic head anterior to the IVC. Lymphoma, carcinoma of the pancreatic head, colon, stomach, lung and breast are the common malignant process to involve these pancreatico-duodenal group of lymph. So this CT scan images on the right hand side, that arrow is showing there is a lymph node. However, on the left hand side there are multiple lymph nodes that white arrow is showing, that is clearly separable from this IVC and aorta. Perisplenic nodes. The perisplenic nodes lie in the splenic hilum and drain the spleen, greater curvature of the stomach and tail of the pancreas. The upper limit of normal for these perisplenic nodes are 10 mm. So this CT scan, this is a case of the lymphoma that demonstrate a enlarged splenic hilum node that is denoting by this black arrow at the splenic hilum. Mesenteric nodes, the small bowel mesentery contains a large number of nodes that accompany the branches of the superior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric vein. The non-Hodgkin lymphoma, leukemia, small bowel neoplasm, ovarian carcinoma and carcinoma of the right and transfer colon are common cause of mesenteric lymphadenopathy. And in benign cases, the tuberculosis is the one of the cause of this mesenteric group of lymph node enlargement. This on the right hand side, the CT scan of a 57 year old woman with a case of the lymphoma, this shows mesenteric lymphadenopathy that white arrow are clearly denoting. On the left hand side, this ultrasound image shows multiple mesenteric lymphadenopathy. The pelvic nodes constitute an extensive nodal group clustered along the common external and internal iliac vessels. abnormality for pelvic node is greater than 15 millimeter. However, if you see the any asymmetry in the areas of the iliac vessel, may also be an indication of the early lymphadenopathy. So, right hand side, the CT scan showing this bilateral common iliac lymph node enlargement. That arrow is showing. However, on the left hand side, that left external iliac nodal enlargement. What are the sonographic evaluation of lymphadenopathy? In the cases of this malignant lymph node, on gray scale, it is usually round or oval. And if the longitudinal and transfer ratio or long or short axis ratio is less than 2, then it is indicative of this malignant lymph node. And if they are eccentric, cortical widening and narrow or absent fat, that is also in favor of malignant lymph node. On color Doppler, if they are avascular, intranodal region present and intranodal vessel displayed are distorted. However, the fatty hilum are maintained in cases of the benign lymph node. Laparoscopic ultrasound, the hilar fat sign and long and short axis diameter ratio is more than 2 in upper abdominal lymph node detected by laparoscopic ultrasound suggests the absence of the malignant infiltration. However, inhomogeneity suggests of malignant infiltration. Like in this ultrasound image, the long and this longitudinal and transfer ratio is more than 5. That suggests this lymph node is in favor of the benign pathology. And if you look at this hilum, that is linear hyperechoic, that is also in favor of the benign pathology. The differentiation of benign and malignant lymph node on power Doppler. The points in favor of the malignant abdominal lymph node are avascular focus, aberrant vessels and subcapsular vessel. However, the point in favor of the benign abdominal lymph node is hilar vessels. These power Doppler ultrasound that shows the peripheral type, mixed type and central type vascularization in bulky lymph node. Guideline for ultrasound guided biopsy. The persistent dominant lymph node of size more than 10 mm in all lymph node chain except for inguinal is reasonable for biopsy. Whether FNA, fine needle aspiration or biopsy. So FNAC can provide a diagnosis in some cases such as metastatic carcinoma, and it may be the only option in an unstable patient with a deep node detected on CT. Utility of FNAC is limited in hematological malignancy, especially in lymphoma, in which lymph node architecture is critical in making the diagnosis. So, which route ideally you should prefer during the biopsy? So, we should choose the shortest and least obstructed path. As in known case of the retropetuvian lymphadenopathy, look for more superficial nodes and that should be more accessible. Endoscopic ultrasound. Endoscopic ultrasound, they are high resolution imaging and they have ability to sample lesion that are often difficult to assess by the other method like the transabdominal. It is a pivotal role in cancer staging for gastrointestinal malignancies. Areas of application, especially in the esophageal malignancies, gastric, pancreatic, ampullary, extrahepatic bile duct and rectal malignancy, it is useful. Esophageal cancer staging with endoscopic ultrasonography. Technique: upper endoscopy with a forward viewing endoscope is usually performed first to localize the tumor precisely and to determine whether dilatation is needed prior to passing the echoendoscope or not. Once the echoendoscope is passed into the stomach, ultrasound imaging is performed on withdrawal of the scope. Specific attention given to the determining the extent of tumor wall invasion, aortic involvement, peritumor lymph nodes, celiac lymph nodes, and liver metastasis. So this right side images that on endoscopy that N1 lymph node involvement in esophageal carcinoma, although they are less than 10 mm in size, the sonographic feature are suspicious for malignancy because due to the round shape, hypoechoic in nature and discrete borders. However, on the left hand side, this image that showing the enlarged hypoechoic without a fatty hilum, and that on cytology that was adenocarcinoma. Rectal cancer staging with endoscopic ultrasound. Malignant appearing lymph nodes are generally round, hypoechoic, well demarcated and more than 10 mm in diameter. Our perirectal lymph nodes are rarely seen in non-malignant transrectal ultrasound. So intra-op ultrasonography that can detect nodal metastasis with high sensitivity, allowing avoidance of unnecessary para-aortic lymphadenopathy in women with ovarian and uterine corpus malignancy. So this schematic diagram that shows the aortocaval lymph node as well as on the right side image that ultrasound image that show the this lymph node, aortocaval group of lymph node. What is the role of the FDG PET and FDG CT PET imaging? The study shows sensitivity and specificity of detection of nodal metastatic disease is comparable with CT and conventional MRI. Simultaneously, detection and quantification of non-nodal malignancy. Quantitative monitoring of the response of nodal and non-nodal metastatic diseases in the entire body to therapeutic intervention are advantages of this FDG PET. So these images, this is a 60-year-old male female with the history of hysterectomy of ovarian carcinoma followed by resection, chemo and radiotherapy. That this bottom images that shows the focal para-aortic lymph node. So dual time point 18F FDG PET imaging for differentiation between the malignant from inflammatory process. The hypothesis of a dual point imaging that is increased FDG accumulation in malignant lesion after a 60 to 90 minute injection, whereas uptake in infectious inflammatory lesion tends to decrease with the time. Early studies showed that dual time point imaging improved accuracy of FDG PET. Considerable overlap between malignant and infectious inflammatory lesion is still seen. So ultrasound appearance in various causes of retroperitoneal lymph node. They usually discrete hypoechoic, anechoic masses both anterior and posterior to great vessel. No posterior acoustic enhancement as seen commonly in the cyst. Nodes may fuse to form a hypoechoic mantle of tissue surrounding aorta and elevating aorta away from the spine. And retroperitoneal lymph node is most commonly in the lymphoma. So 25% cases of Hodgkin's and 50% cases of non-Hodgkin lymphoma at presentation. 80 to 90% accuracy of ultrasonography in detecting retroperitoneal nodal lymphoma. It is also useful for detecting extranodal disease like bowel visceral involvement. So this ultrasound images that showing the hypoechoic enlarged necrotic lymph node. This was the patient having the AIDS and related infection in immunocompromised subjects. What are the imaging finding on the MR of lymph nodes? The overall accuracy of gadolinium enhanced MRI for the detection of nodal metastasis is moderate. Incorporating contrast enhancement in the malignancy criteria substantially improved the sensitivity. However, the role of diffusion-weighted imaging added to conventional MRI resulted in the detection of pelvic lymph nodes. Although detection of lymph node increased with the diffusion-weighted imaging, still over 60% of the pelvic lymph node was missed compared to the number removed by surgery. Ultra small super paramagnetic iron oxide particle imaging. This USPIO is a negative contrast agent, one which is taken up by benign lymph node with preserved nodal architectures. Areas of metastatic nodal infiltration due to the lack of reticuloendothelial structure and macrophages therefore do not accumulate the USPIO, resulting in a lack of uptake in malignant lymph node. This Harrison et al. Reported 80 patients with the prostate cancer where USPIO enhanced MRI increased sensitivity for detection of lymph node from 35% to 90%. So, take home message. The presence of nodal tenderness suggests an infectious or inflammatory pathology. Whereas a non-tender stony hard lymph node indicate a malignancy. Hyperechoic center or long axis short axis ratio more than 2 suggests the absence of malignant infiltration. However, inhomogeneity was suggestive of the malignant infiltration. On power Doppler imaging, malignant abdominal lymph node shows avascular, aberrant or subcapsular vessel, while if the lymph node is showing the hilar vessel, that are in favor of the lymph node. Thank you.